Good morning to one and all. Today we are going to see depth first search and breadth first search. Depth first search is a recursive algorithm which keeps on iterating again and again until we find a solution. In depth first search, the search continues from node level and continues till the node last node. The problem with that depth first search is that it can encounter an infinite loop and it keeps on iterating. So to avoid this, we can use breadth first search. The problem with breadth first search is that breadth first search iterates in level wise. The main constraint with depth first search and breadth first search is memory problem. First let us see the pseudocode of depth first search. To use depth first search, we are using the data structure called stack. Stack uses a property called first in and last out. Why we are going for data stack is that in stack, whatever element which is entering the stack at last will be processed first. We see an example of breadth first search. In this example, it is a graph which contains 5 nodes and 4 edges. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and these are the nodes. And the lines which are connecting the nodes are called as edges. Using the example, we are going to see how the depth first search travels and find the solutions. Initially, we are going to start with the source code, which is 1. After the source code, it will iterate. There are two options, 2 and 3. Out of these two nodes, we are going to process with only one node, and that is 2. So, in the second step, from the source node, it reaches the 2. And after 2, it will proceed to the next level. Because it is a depth first search, it will iterate from the node wise, not with level wise. So, after processing the 1, it goes to 2. Without processing 2, after processing 3, it goes to the next child, and again there are two options, 4 and 5, out of which it chooses 4. So once it reaches the 4, there are no more further nodes, so it stops the iteration and it again reverse, it retracts to the previous node. This process is called as backtracking. Backtracking is the process of going to your previous nodes and search for the other optimal solutions. So here, once it reaches 4, it goes back to the node 2. And again, it sees for any other options from 2. There is another unvisited node called 5. So it goes to 5. And after it reaches the 5, again, it is a dead end, so it cannot proceed further. So it again revert back to 2. After going back to 2, all the nodes are already visited. So again, it goes to its previous parent node, 1. In the 1, there is an unvisited node called 3. So it goes to 3. And from 3, it searches for other alternate options. If there are no options, it stops from the 3 and it pops out from the stack. So once all the nodes are visited, it pops all the elements from your stack and finally it returns the state. So the order of visiting is given below. It goes from 1, 2, 4, and then again it backtracks to 2 and goes to 5, then it backtracks to 2, and then it backtracks to 1, and last it goes to 3. So these are the steps which follows in depth first search. The problem with this search is, suppose if you are proceeding with starting node and you are iterating through all the nodes, if it is an infinite loop, it keeps on iterating and it will never come back to its original position. This is the problem in depth first search. And also in optimization, if you are considering it that point of view, depth first search is actually an optimized solution because it consumes very less memory compared to other searching techniques. So in memory constraint, it is the best problem, but if we are considering an infinite loop, it is not a best solution. So to avoid this, we can use breadth first search. And this is the complexity of your depth first search. It has a complexity of V and E, V plus E. V is all your vertices and E is all your edges. If you combine all these three, you are getting V plus E, the total complexity of your algorithm. And as I already mentioned, breadth first search travels in level wise, not in node wise. So the main problem in breadth first search is that it consumes more memory compared to depth first search. Let's see an example of breadth first search. And this is the pseudocode of breadth first search. In contrast with depth first search, breadth first uses a queue data structure because queue uses a logic called first in, first out. So whichever node enters first, all the child nodes of the current node will be processed, then it proceeds to the next node. But in depth first search, whichever node enters the last, its child and its child will be processed. So in this example, initially the source node will be processed. After processing the source node, this will be marked as a closed node and all the child node will be marked as open node, because this will not be processed again, and all the child node will be processed in the next iteration. So the next iteration will goes to 1, 2 and 3. After processing all these nodes, it will check for its siblings or childs. So 1 has 4 and 5, 2 has 6, 3 has 7. So after completing this level 1, it goes to the next level, level 2. In this level 2, it processes 4, 5, 6 and 7. So in this, the problem is that it will never enter infinite loop compared to depth search, but in each iteration it consumes more memory. In this example, consider this. It has a memory size of 1. Here it has a memory size of 3. Here it has a memory size of 4. So as the level increases, the memory size will keep on increases in breadth first search. But in depth first search, in each iteration you are going to process only 2 nodes at any instant. So the memory consumption compared to breadth first search, depth first is better. But if there is an infinite loop, depth first search will not provide an optimal solution, whereas the breadth first search will provide an optimal solution. To see an example, consider this example. Initially we are starting from 5. After processing the 5, it goes to 1 and 2. In 1 and 2, it has a child called 3 and 4. So in the next step, it processes 3 and 4. After processing 3 and 4, it goes for the next loop. And there is another child called 5. So it will process 5. And these are the steps followed. And here also the complexity is same compared to depth first search and breadth first search, but the difference is only with the memory optimization and your time complexity. See, these are the comparison between depth first search and breadth first search. In breadth first search, it proceeds in vertex wise. So it will provide, it will iterate, consider this example, it will iterate from A and will process to B, then it will goes to D. This is provided in depth first search. In breadth first search, it will iterate level wise. So initially it will process so slow, but after the iteration it increases, the number of nodes will get increased in breadth first search, but in depth first search, as the iteration increases, the number of nodes will never get increases. It will be remain constant throughout your algorithm. And breadth first search uses queue, whereas your depth first search uses stack for implementation. And it is wide and short in breadth first search, because after every iteration, the number of nodes gets increased in your breadth first search, whereas in depth first search, the number of nodes will never get increases. It will be constant throughout your program. So it is narrow and long. Why it is long? Because it keeps on iterating in a node wise until the solution is found. So it is narrow and long. And in this example, how is the iteration proceeds? Here I have given, in breadth first search, it will process A, then BC, then DE, FG. In depth first search, it will process A, then it will go to B, then it will go to D. After the end node is reached, it will again backtrack to B and it goes to E. So after E, there are no nodes, so again it will backtrack to B to check whether there are any unvisited nodes. If there are any unvisited nodes, it will proceed. Otherwise, it will backtrack to A and proceed to the next loop. The next node is C. After C, there are two options, F and G, so it will proceed to F. And after F, then it is the edge node, so there are no further nodes, so it will backtrack and goes to G. The iteration order is given below. See, it is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and that is A, B, D, E, G, F, G. Even though the order of iteration is different, both the algorithm will visit each and every nodes in this process.